Now, let me walk you guys through the test and so that you better understand everything that's going on. Along the way, I'll point out to you all of the benefits of the page object model and how it helps you to have a more stable test. And then we're going to wrap things up where I'm going to add another test live so that you can actually see what's going on and how to further enhance your tests utilizing the page object model. So we obviously have our class. Now, this class is not named appropriately. Normally, you can name it based on your functionality or a feature that you're testing. And each of our classes inherits from a base test class. If I navigate to a base test class, what it does is two very simple actions. It does a setup and a teardown. So in the setup, what it's going to do is initialize a Firefox driver with a maximized Windows state for every single test. And in the teardown, if our driver is not equal to null, we're going to quit the driver, and that's it. So for every single test, we're going to initialize a Firefox driver and then tear it down. That is the beauty of utilizing not only the page object model, but classes, is that you can remove a bunch of duplicated functionality. So now in the future, if I needed to create another class, I can simply inherit from the base test and I would automatically get the instantiation of the driver and the teardown of the driver out of the box without having to write a single line of code. Obviously, the beauty of inheritance. Now, inside of the test, what goes on is actually pretty simple. All we do is create a new page. You usually name the page according to the actual web page that you may be looking at. So when we were interacting with the courses page, I created a courses page. I would recommend that a good pattern for utilizing the page object pattern is every single HTML page that you interact with deserves its own class. So when I instantiate this new page, I obviously pass it the driver that we created in our base test. And this driver gets assigned to the courses page variable. And now we can utilize it throughout our page for whatever purposes we need. For example, like the goto method. The goto method will navigate directly to this URL. A sign-in link is gonna click the sign-in link and then return us a student login page. You guys can see how each of the methods encapsulates the functionality that directly interacts with the web page, therefore saving us from any possible changes. Because if I needed to change, for example, handling this sign-in link, the only place that I would need to change it is up here where the sign-in link is identified. And by the way, you guys can see up here that I also have, I only have one element, that I have my elements. We can refer to it as a UI map. And all my elements will be stored in these properties that retrieve me the element with its identifier. And whenever anything changes, all I have to do is update the identifier right here.